Gone are the days when a 6.5 GPA and decent GET score could get a student into any tier 1 college. Now, we live in an increasingly competitive world, and that's the sole reason parents find themselves micromanaging their children these days. Why not? It's too challenging to watch their child fail. So helicopter parenting has now become a necessary ingredient in the recipe for successful adulthood. They act like personal mentors who assist their kids with everything from sports equipment to science fair projects. Quite often, kids with that type of support are able to gain a slight competitive advantage. Dear parents, do you know such parenting takes a toll on kids in the long term by reducing their cognitive, emotional, and physical development? Well, you must be wondering how parenting style can be the reason for their overall development. Then, you have got to watch this video till the end. Here, in this video, we are going to talk about how helicopter parenting can backfire on your kids. Helicopter parenting involves parents taking decisions for their children, reducing their need to problem solve and make their own decisions. These decision-making skills won't grow unless they are given the chance to exercise, fail, fall, and learn. The area of the brain that deals with decision-making skills is housed in the prefrontal part of the brain, which is found to only have fully developed at 25 years of age. By not letting them fall and learn and do better next time, parents hinder the development of the brain and with it the copious capacities needed to thrive socially, personally, and academically. Parents exert too much control over situations and don't let their children handle the challenge. This hinders the development of self-regulatory abilities in kids. The over-involvement of parents makes the child believe that his parents will not trust him if he does something independently. This leads to lack of self-esteem and confidence. By doing this, we deprive our kids from the opportunity to be creative, to problem solve, to develop coping skills, to build resilience, to figure out what makes them happy, and finally, to figure out who they are. Although we over-involve ourselves to protect our kids, our behavior actually delivers that they are nothing without us. When parents try to clean up the mess in the first place, children fail to learn through failure, disappointments, or loss. As a result, they miss out on the opportunity to learn valuable life lessons from the mistakes they make. When over-parented kids get to school or college, they come across several troubles coping with the various new situations, such as a roommate who has a different sense of clean, a professor who wants a revision to the paper but won't say specifically what is wrong, or a friend who isn't being so friendly anymore. In short, overprotection tends to develop frustration in kids as they enter the workforce. Helicopter parenting increases a child's depression and anxiety levels. They are always looking for guidance, and when left alone, they become too nervous to take a decision. These kids are less open to new ideas and activities. This in return leads to depression or anxiety. At the end of the day, we want our kids to be happy. However, driving them does the opposite. It robs them of the ability to discover who they are and what internally drives them. So what do you do? Shocked? Thinking it's totally irresponsible and dangerous? Well, let's be clear with the message. Think as if your child is a tightrope walker in his life. His aim is to walk that tightrope as safely as possible and get through the walk with his head held high, a sense of accomplishment and joy. But if you hold his hands, he is definitely going to do it well, but won't learn it for himself. As a result, he will fall out on the ground once you leave him. Yes, you got it right. Be the net. Initially, your child will get up there with fear in his heart, but at some point, he will get the courage to start that walk as he knows that if he falls, you are there to catch him. Eventually, they start gaining confidence in themselves. Their sweating subsides and their wobbly knees dissipate. result. They will be happy because they know they can do it. So how would you raise your child? As said by D.H. Lawrence, the first rule is leave them. The second rule is leave them. And the third one is leave them alone. That is the whole beginning. That's all for today, guys. Sharing has no bounds and limits. So please like and share it with all the parents you know. Also, don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any updates. Until then, take care. Thanks for watching.